Well, hello, everybody, and happy Saturday. It is time for Date Night with Lisa. This is Lisa Freeman coming to you live on Saturday, December 3rd, 2022 at 7 p.m. And I am running a couple minutes late. I did not have time to get everything ready, but we're just going to wing it. So I was sitting here making bows right before I hit the live button. So how is everybody doing? I haven't even gotten onto the channel yet to see if I'm live, but I see comments, so I'm guessing I am. So hold on one second. Let me get my computer going so I can see the comments, and then we'll be all caught up. So I hope you guys had an awesome day. If I didn't say this, this is Lisa Freeman from stampingwithlisa.com, and I have a fun thing planned for you tonight. So I've got two things here. We're making the card, but I wanted to show you where I got the idea for the card, and that was from my friend in Upline, Faith. So she came over the other day and we made this cute little coaster. So it is a coaster, just like I think it's 3 inches, maybe 3.5 inches square. Let me measure it and see. Hold on. It is 3.5 inch square. So you can order these, or if you go to a restaurant and they have some of these little coasters, you can always take a few. But these were just some plain ones that she had, and we made this. And you could make it into an ornament if you want to. Just punch a hole and put some ribbon and you could make it an ornament. And so I had planned a totally different idea for today, not even Christmas. And I sat down, started to make it, and I didn't like the way it came out. So then I started all over again. And I was like, I don't know what I'm going to make tonight. I have no idea. So this was sitting on the table, and I said, huh, I think I could make that into a card. So voila, this is what I came up with. So it's basically the same idea. I just took these two papers and the gold and made it into a card here, and then just embossed the back piece and put some different words on it, but it's similar. So I have to give her credit because that's basically where I got the idea from. So if you want to make this as an ornament, you just make it into a 3.5 by 3.5. I don't have the set that the bird comes from, so I don't even know what set it's in, actually. But I think it's in that set maybe with the moose or something, and the raccoon, or I'm not exactly sure, but I don't have it. So you know, I don't really do cutesy stuff, so I think it is adorable, but I don't have it, so I didn't put that on my card. So this is what we're gonna be making tonight, and it is super easy. So I decided to go ahead and do 5 of them, so that we could be together more than 5 minutes. So we're gonna do like 5 cards in 30 minutes because they are super easy. You don't even have to stamp anything except for joy and the little fern things on the inside. And that comes from Merriest Moments. So we're using joy from that. And this set is retiring. I'm not sure if it's still available or not. I told you guys last time, once that sale starts, everything's gonna sell out quick. And a lot of stuff is sold out already. So if there's something you want, you really need to order it right away. And thank you to everybody who's ordered. I don't think this was on sale, so they probably still have it. The dyes are on sale though, super, super, super cheap, like dirt cheap. I think 60% off the dyes were that go with this. So even if you can't get the stamp set, you might want to get the dies because it comes with the embossing folder too, which is an awesome deal. So you can use it without the stamp set. So I think the embossing folder and the dies together was like $15. So that is a great deal. But that's what we're using tonight, and the little fern here. And then we're also using the snowflakes, which were $2. I think they are sold out now. I bought a ton, and somebody sent me a message and said, thanks for buying all the snowflakes. You didn't even save me any. And I hope they were joking, but there was plenty left because I ordered a bunch. Then I went back like 6 hours later and ordered a few more. So I did not buy them all. And then we are using the embossing folder Time Worn Type. That one goes for the back piece here. So all of the back piece are embossed with this one. And then this one is for this piece right here. So I don't know if you can see it on there. I'll show you that here. Hold on. I'll show you one up close. And we're going to be coloring that with white ink so it'll pop out. So I've already embossed that. And I stuck three of them at a time in the folder. So I had the pieces already cut ahead of time, and I just laid down three of them because they're 3 inches by 2 inches. So you could fit three of them at a time and emboss in there. So that's what I did with those. So I got everything ready to go. So, and then I got four bows done. So I'll do one bow for you. And then we need those. And then in case you missed the last one, oh, let me say hello to everybody. Sorry, I forgot. Oh, Deborah, you're on here live tonight. Hello. Hey, Tony. Hey, Cynthia. Hey, Joyce. Hey, Spice Girl. Hey, Terry. Hey, Diana. Someone to use up all their shiny snowflakes. You know, I have so many of these snowflakes, and I'm going to be giving a lot of them away. So I didn't buy them all for me. And I am going to do some more mystery boxes, too. So stay tuned for those. They'll be coming soon because I have a ton of stuff that's retiring. Plus, I bought a bunch of retired stuff. So I'm going to be baking some killer boxes to go with you guys. So that'll probably be, I don't know, in the next couple weeks or so. Well, actually, we can't sell it until after it retires. So I guess I'll have to wait till January. So right after Christmas, we'll have an after Christmas sale. Hey, Stephanie. Hey, Patricia. Hey, Robin. Hey, Dolores. Hey, Jana. Let's see. Who am I missing? Ina. Regina. Hey, Beth. Let's see. Sherry. Hey, Faith. Hey, Sandy. Hi from Missouri. Love this card. Thank you. Terry says, I sent out 12. If I had Spice Girl's address, you would get one. You sent out 12 what? Christmas cards? Well, I hope you have my address. You can send me one. let's see. I didn't get any Christmas cards today in the mail. I went and checked. I put all the card kits in the mail today, though. So if you ordered, oh shoot, I don't even have them in here anymore. If you ordered the card kit from last time, so the one that was from November 15th to the 30th, that was the blue reindeer and tree ornament looking card. Those went out today in the mail. So you should be getting them this week. Oh, Audrey said that. Audrey's the one who said I stole all the snowflakes. There are still some left. What? Okay, Audrey just said there are still some snowflakes left. Oh, good. Okay, so Kitty Cat got some too. So they're not even sold out yet. So they're only $2. This is the best bargain in town. If you have not gotten these, you get 24 of these snowflakes for $2. That is like a killer deal. So if they're still left, I would go get some. Merriest Moments is still available. Okay, good. But this, oh, embossing folder and dies are sold out. Okay. Okay, let's see. 35 cards Connie made. I haven't done any cards. What? Faith, I've made like 800,000 cards and you could have copied all of them. You guys should have made more than 28. Well, you can make 5 of these tonight because they're super easy. If you guys missed last video, 2 days ago. This was the video from 2 days ago. This is the next card kit. So if you have ordered since the 1st, which is 2 days ago, this will be the card kit that you get. 3 sets of supplies to make this one. And if your order is over $50 and you use the host code, and you guys are doing really, really, really well with the host code. So thank you, thank you, thank you. I've only had 3 people so far this time order without the host code. So that makes my life much easier. And then if your order is over $100, I forgot the rhinestones again. You're going to get these rhinestones, the whole pack, not the dusty ones, but a new pack to go with that. So, and then hopefully if you're a demonstrator, you got this in the mail already. It's awesome, awesome, awesome. My stuff is supposed to come on Monday. So I will be showing you some new stuff on Tuesday, hopefully, Tuesday night, because I should have it all. And Don't forget that retiring sale. So lots and lots of good things on sale for you guys. And if you're a demonstrator, order it on a demonstrator order and you can get free celebration stuff. Because for every $50 you spend, you get free celebration items. So make sure if you're placing an order and you're a demonstrator, and that means you're not ordering from me, you're ordering from yourself, do it on a demonstrator order and you earn free celebration. So for every $50 you order, you get a free item out of here right now if you are a demonstrator. So that's only for demonstrators. Customers can't get celebration until next month, but demonstrators can get it now. So always do that. Free stuff is good. Okay. Oh, Robin says, wow, wonderful snowflakes are still available. $2.40 for 24. So, oh, I thought they were $2. They're $2.40. So still a great deal. Just make the quilt card. It's so beautiful. Let's see. Finally found the live chat. Hey, Myrna. Still no books. Spice has done 22 cards so far. Well, I think I've made probably at least 50 or 70 cards just in the videos with you guys. And then I've also had class and stuff. All right. So I remembered one thing today, and that is my crack candy recipe. So I wanted to show you guys, this is what I use. I always used the Wilton melts, but then Michael stopped selling them. And the only place that I have found them now is at Walmart. And Walmart is always sold out of them. So you can get the Wilton ones at Walmart if you can find them. But these are the brand that Michael's carries now. And they were on sale for $1.99 last week when I bought these. So I bought like a bunch of them. I use 3 or 4 bags per batch. So this is my original recipe that I wrote down for you guys. I kind of wing it. I don't really use a recipe anymore because I've made it so many times. So I actually make it a little bit bigger than this, but I don't measure anything. So when I do it, instead of 3 bags, I use 4. And then I use a little bit more peanut butter, a little bit more marshmallows, a little bit more peanuts and Rice Krispies. So I just adjust it to make a bigger batch. But this batch makes a ton. So you have to have a bowl, I'm not kidding, like this big, like a big giant popcorn bowl to make it. So I know you can't see my hands how big they are, but you need a giant bowl to make this because it makes a ton. All right, so here is the recipe. I'm going to hold it up. Let me see how close I can get it so you can take a screenshot of it. Is that too close? Yes, that's too close. Hold on. Okay, I think that is in the screen. Okay, so see if you can take a screenshot of that. So if you can't read my handwriting, it says 3 bags of white chocolate melts, which that's this, these meltables, this little disc. You do not want to use white chocolate chips. White chocolate chips do not work. You can use the bark that comes like at the grocery store. It looks like ice cubes. You can use that if you want, but I find that this is better tasting. And then you need a cup of peanut butter, 2 cups of mini marshmallows, 2 cups dry roasted peanuts, and 4 or 5 cups Rice Krispies. And these 3 items you mix in a bowl ahead of time. So the marshmallows, peanuts, and Rice Krispies, put that in a bowl and mix it up. Just kind of stir it up. And then you're going to dump your chocolate, your white chocolate. I guess you could use regular chocolate. I don't know. I've never tried it. I always use white chocolate. Melt it in the microwave. I do like 30 seconds at a time, stir it, 30 seconds, stir it, and it usually takes about 2 to 3 minutes depending on your microwave. Then you stir in the peanut butter, and I don't even measure the peanut butter. I just take a big giant spoonful or 2 spoonfuls. It's usually about half of a jar of peanut butter, regular size jar of peanut butter. And then stir it up. So it should be really, really creamy. And then you pour all that on top of all the Rice Krispies and marshmallows and stuff. Stir it up. And then you just plop it on, get all your wax paper ready ahead of time on all your counters, cover them in wax paper, and then just plop it by spoonfuls all over the wax paper and let it sit for about 20 or 30 minutes. It'll harden up. And then you just put them all in a Ziploc bag and, Then when you're ready to give them out, I just put them in little cello bags with a ribbon and give them out to everybody. So that is my crack candy. So once you try that, it is going to be like your favorite thing you've ever had. So it's so delicious. Spice Girl said she's made lots of candy, but only 22 cards. All of your cards are fun folds. Oh, huh. I don't make a lot of fun folds. Your screen is too blurry, so I can't read it. Oh, darn, kitty cat. Let me try it one more time. If I put it down, maybe if I just don't hold it and I just put it down there, you'll see it. Can you see it if I don't move it? Maybe that'll be better. I tried to turn off the autofocus thing, so it shouldn't focus like it was doing. 200 cards. Sherry has made 200 cards. Wow. Okay. Karen says she finds herself casing a lot of my cards. Good. Haven't gotten mine either. Aw. Looks delicious. Love white chocolate. Have a crock pot recipe that uses white chocolate. Oh, that would be good. But I just use it in the microwave. It's really easy. And you could really mix in anything you wanted to with this. I've seen other people kind of change it and add in like, you know, M&Ms or other things like pretzels and different things. But this has always been my basic recipe. If you want to add other things to it, you can. Robin says the only candy crack she has is the saltine crackers, brown sugar. That's one of my favorite things. Oh my gosh, I love that stuff. It's like toffee. When you take the crackers and you put them down in the pan and then pour all the caramely stuff on top and then bake it. And then you take it out and put the chocolate chips on top. Oh my gosh, that's so good. Love it. All right, so let's do some stamping. Enough talking. All right, so what you're going to need is 5 pieces of Evening Evergreen, and I've already folded these in half. It's 5.5 by 8.5. And then you're going to need 5 pieces of white. That's for the inside, 5.25 by 4. 5 pieces of white that's embossed. This is embossed with the Time Worn Type. That's 5.25 by 4. Somebody asked me to use a white pen. I mean, not a white pen, a black pen. I am using a black pen, so they said they couldn't see it. But I do use a black pen for this, so I'm not sure. Maybe if you make your screen bigger, then you can see it better. I don't know. And then we've got these little pieces. So these are the trees. These are 3x2, 5 of those. And then these are also 3x2, and these are the ones that I embossed with the snowflakes. And that's 3x2. Sorry, I messed the 2 up. And then I've got 5 pieces of distressed gold. And they're all over the place. So let's put those there. And then 5 pieces of these little white. That's for the words. So that's this little piece here. And that's the gold here. And the gold I didn't really measure. It's about 1/4 inch. But what I did is I just took a piece and I just kind of went chop, 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 chop. And I didn't really measure it, so it's probably a little bit bigger than 1/4 inch, but it's 3 inches across. So everything's 3 inches across. And then these little pieces are 1.25 by 1/2. So get a screenshot of this, and then we'll get started. All right. Reading some comments real quick. Okay. Yeah, I love getting happy mail. So if you guys want to send me stuff, feel free to send me stuff. I love it. All right, so everybody got a screenshot? Oops, sorry, that's crooked. That's crooked. I don't see Starla on here tonight, so she's not taking pictures. But she did my tutorial for me last time, so I'll have that. And those of you that got the kit that I mailed out today, I'll send you guys the tutorial also for that one. All right, let's get started. So here we go. Take off all these post-its and get started. So most of the work is already done. We don't have to do much to put it all together. So we don't need this one or this one. Or, well, this one we do have to stamp. So this goes here with that. These have to be stamped. So let's go ahead and do the stamping first. So we've got our words, and the only color we're using, well, we're using white too. Oh, let me do that first because that takes a minute to dry. So what we're gonna do is swipe the white across here. So let me get some scrap paper. Okay, so we're gonna take these pieces right here and our white craft pad, which mine is kind of old and dirty looking. But you're gonna take it and you're just gonna swipe it really lightly across this just to make those snowflakes pop more. So there you go. So that just makes your snowflakes pop so then you can see them. See how much better they look now? And it does take a few minutes to dry. It'll be a little bit tacky. So just let it sit for a few minutes. So you're just lightly rubbing that pad across it to get it to pop out your snowflakes. So we'll do that on all of them. Somebody put a comment and said, why do you make the same cards over and over and over? Instead of just making like one, and then your video would only be like 5 or 10 minutes. And I said, well, exactly, that's the whole point. So I think you guys like having a video that's a little bit longer because then you can watch and socialize. Because for you guys, I think it's more the entertainment and the socialization when you're on the live. And if you're not watching the live, you can always fast forward through stuff. So there you go. Because if I made a quick card, you'd be like, oh, you're done already. We weren't done talking. Because I know you talk amongst yourselves a lot. All right, so we're done with that. So that was the white craft ink. Now we're going to use the evening evergreen for our words. So we've got these little teeny pieces here to put joy on. So hopefully I can get this straight without getting my head right in the middle. And I brought a couple extra of those just in case I get it crooked. I was using my not really good paper cutter for this, so that it's got like the frayed edges a little bit. Oh, that came out dark. You can tell like where my pad has more ink. So that came out a lot darker. What a difference. Ink it up in the corner. Where you use it the most in the middle has less ink than in the corners it does. All right, so this is 1/2 inch by 1 1/4 inch. And I just stamped it and then I cut it down to see how much I need it. All right, so I got, oh, all those came out pretty good. That one's just a little bit light, but that's okay. All right, so we're done with that one. Then we're gonna take our fern and we're gonna do that on the inside piece. So we're done with those. So on the inside of the card, we're gonna have this little fern thing. And I'm gonna stamp it 3 times because that's always my favorite thing to do. So 1, 2, 3, just like that. I love just having dark, medium, and light. The other good thing about doing the same card 5 times is if you miss it the first time, maybe by the 2nd or 3rd or 4th time, you'll get it. In case you're talking too much. And we all know who talks the most and should be staying after for detention in class every time. And that would be Spice Girl. If we were in a real class, she would definitely be getting in trouble for talking too much. She's the life of the party. I used to always joke in my classes that I've always had a lot of talkative people in my classes, which is good because then it's more fun. But I always joke and say, okay, if you guys don't stop talking, you're going to have to stay after class for detention. And they're all like, yes, because they all want to stay longer. But when I was a teacher, I think I've told you guys that before, I used to be a math teacher, a high school math teacher. Nobody wanted to stay after for detention then because they're like, oh, no, 1 more minute of math. No. All right, so then we're just gonna put this together. So I think I'm gonna do the inside first. And these are still drying just a little bit. So we're gonna use our green glue. And see how fast these go? So those of you who have not done your cards, you could just do these really fast. I should have done this one for my project last time for the card kit, because I have a lot of this paper left over, these little pieces. So I could get rid of them like that. Maybe I don't want to use it for my next card kit, because then you guys would have already seen it. But maybe I'll throw in an extra one sometime. I love that fern. I really like that stamp set, and I'm kind of bummed that it's retiring. Because it was funny, I had it last year and I never used it. And then this year I've used it quite a lot. Because it's a really pretty stamp set. But I hope they bring back another poinsettia one next year that's like kind of vintage looking. Because we had that really, really pretty poinsettia stamp set. And they took it away and brought this one. Remember that really, really, really pretty one we had last year? What was it called? Poinsettia Petals, I think. It was so pretty. I loved, loved, loved that stamp set. They always take away my favorites. So, this might be one of the last Christmas cards I do because, like I said, I am getting my new stuff on Monday, hopefully, maybe Tuesday, but hopefully Monday because I two-day aired it. So if I get it Monday, if I get it Tuesday, I probably won't have time to make something, but if I get it Monday, then I can make something brand new for my project. Are you guys getting tired of Christmas cards yet? Or you want new stuff or you want Christmas cards still? Or you just want something totally different? Because most of the new mini catalog is a lot of flowers and stuff. So what do you guys think? You want more Christmas ideas or new stuff? I still need some Christmas cards, though, because I don't think I've made enough. Even with all of my classes and stuff, I don't think I have enough. Because I try to, if you guys send me a Christmas card, I try to send one back to you. But right now, I don't have enough Christmas cards, so I better get busy. Because I'm sending out some to my downline soon, once I get those packs ready. This is coming out better all of a sudden. Oh, and a couple people asked about the maternity body pillow thing I talked about last time. I put the link in the description box below the video. So if you just look below the video, click on the little arrow that takes you down to the description. And the link to the Amazon is on there. And that's the one that I got. It was only $30. Maybe not even $30. I think it was between $25 and $30. All right, so there we go. Those are all done. All right, so then we're going to put these on the white piece. So the trees go on the top. And the snowflakes go on the bottom. Let's just do one at a time. So that goes on the top. You got to make sure you get this straight, because then if the top is crooked, the bottom is going to be crooked too. And you don't want that because they're just going to butt up next to each other. See, that one's a little bit crooked. And then we're going to put the gold right across the middle. And the easiest thing to do with that is just put a little strip of glue right there in the middle and then lay that down right on top. Instead of trying to get it on the piece and then flipping it over. That way you don't get your fingers messy. So let me read comments. How much white almond bark? I don't know, because the bags are 12 ounces. So I'm not sure how much the white almond bark is, but you would need, for the recipe, it's 3 bags of the 12 ounces. So that's 36 ounces. So just kind of measure the same amount of white almond bark if you use that instead. Let's see. Oops, just skipped a whole bunch of stuff. I'm ready for new stuff. Okay, almost everybody is saying new stuff, new stuff, new stuff. Poinsettia petals, what? Your cards are done. No. Sue says, I like the cartoon where the librarian is questioning who put math books in the horror section. That would have been me. Oh, that's so funny. That's so funny. I like it longer, plus it is social, yes. Spice Girl is the class clown, that is for sure. But we love her, don't we? Oh, Spice Girl says she has to save her money because she's going to come here. I think y'all should take a road trip and come visit. We could have a lot of fun. Get a hotel room and we'll have a party and stuff. Somebody get something like at the beach or something. Oh, Terry says, I looked at the body pillow, but where would my husband and dog sleep? I don't know. That's why I said it takes up like half the bed, but I sleep by myself, so it doesn't matter if I take up half the bed. But I have a king-size bed, so if you have a king-size bed, it should still work. Becky says, get rid of the husband. Sherry says, more Christmas cards because we don't all have the new product like I do until January. Okay. I need to finish up cards tonight. Do not trust myself. Who's not? 3 packs of white bark. No. Connie, if you get this, this is the white melts. They're 12 ounces each. You need 3 of these bags. So if you're using the bark, I think that bark comes in like a 2-pound brick. So that would be about 2 pounds is 32 ounces. So that would be almost the same as 3 bags of the melts. So I would either stick with the melts or just use 1 pack of the bark, I think. I'm pretty sure it's two pounds because I've used that before for other stuff, but it's harder to melt it too because they're in bigger blocks. So I really like the melts better. But if you can't find them for some reason and have to use the bark, I'm pretty sure just 1 big block would do it. Maybe cut back a little bit on the peanut butter and the Rice Krispies and stuff. And you can also change it. Like, I like the marshmallows the best. So I add extra marshmallows and less peanuts because I'm not a huge peanut person. And the peanut butter gives it enough peanut flavor. So I like lots of marshmallows in mine. So you can always change it up to whatever you want. But that's the basic recipe that I started with. Like, I think I was, let me see. It was at least 35 years ago because I had just started teaching and there was a teacher that gave me that recipe and she said it was her family's secret recipe and she gave it to me and she made me promise not to give it to anybody else. Well, that didn't happen because I've given it to probably over 1,000 people, probably more than that. But I've seen the recipe other places, so it wasn't her secret family recipe. But she's the one that gave it to me. But it actually, there was a contest here one time for a cookie contest. And the winner of the cookie contest was actually that recipe. And it's the only difference was they had taken at the end, dark chocolate chips and melted it and then drizzled on the top. So that was the only difference in that recipe and my recipe. So it actually won a baking contest. So I didn't feel bad sharing the recipe. I feel like if you have a really good recipe, you should share it with people. Because why wouldn't you want to share? I know some people are really, you know, tight with their recipes and they don't want to share because they don't want anybody else to have it. But that's silly. Why would you not want people to eat your good stuff? Because Everybody knows where they got the recipe from. It's not like Kentucky Fried Chicken or Chick-fil-A chicken recipe. But it's funny because I ask people, you know, who work there, like at Chick-fil-A and stuff, and I'm like, do you know the secret ingredient? Because some people say the secret ingredient is pickle juice that makes their chicken taste so good and so juicy. But they all say it already comes prepackaged and they just dump it in the bowl. So nobody knows what the secret is. All right, so whoops. Just messed that up. Let me turn that over because I don't want the glue on there. It's gonna be sticky. All right, so we've got almost all the pieces put together. But then we've got to do the bling and some people really liked my Wink of Stella technique last time. They'd never heard of spanking Stella. So they thought that was hysterical. Now this is all sticky. I'm getting sticky everywhere. So you can always spank Stella. If you don't have the shimmer paint spray, you can always use Stella. It's basically the exact same thing, except Stella's in a pen and the spray is like in a spray bottle, but it's pretty much the exact same stuff. Now that's all sticky. All right, so then these are all gonna go on with dimensionals. So I need a new pack of dimensionals. And let me see. See some more comments. You guys are doing comments so fast, I can't keep up. Let's see. Oh, Dolly, first time live, and I am your favorite. Hey, 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 thanks for joining us tonight. Oh, Tony says she thinks Joanne Fabric sells the melts and maybe Hobby Lobby. Probably. They do sell some kind of, might not be that brand, because I think that brand is for Michaels, but Michael's always had the Wilton ones, and I always waited till right before Christmas when they would go on sale for like $1.69 or something. The lowest I saw them was $1.99 this year, and they used to be 16 ounces back in the day. Then they downsized them. But I know Walmart still has Wilton, but this brand is pretty good. I used them the last couple years, and it's just as good. But, yeah, probably, I'm pretty sure they probably do have them. And, let's see. I just gave me a deep. Picking through Ohio on your way to... Oh, Tony says, Debbie Spicer, when coming through Ohio on your way to see Lisa, pick me up. Is Ohio, like, on the way from Arizona to here? I don't know. I'm not very good at geography. My subject was math, and I'm not very good at geography. I know like the East Coast and the West Coast, but I don't know much in the middle. I kind of know the bottom or all around the edges, but the middle of the country, forget it. I'm not very good. Like if you said, where is North Dakota? I would have no idea. I know it's somewhere up in the top, in the middle. But I don't know which state it is. My daughter used to know every single state, where they all were and everything. And I was like, man, how do you remember all that? Okay, so then we're just going to put all these down. And, all right, how many of you guys are going to make this card, you think? This is really easy. And it's really pretty, too. And I love it with the white making those snowflakes pop. That just really adds a lot to it. Yeah, Spice Girl, you and Terry would have fun in the car. You'd be like, what was that movie? With Susan Sarandon and, Thelma and Louise. You'd be like Thelma and Louise driving in the Cadillac convertible across the country. That would be fun. I know. I can't wait till I retired and I can start traveling all over the place. My sister-in-law does Fruit Loop cereal. Yeah, I've had a lot of, like, there's one with Chex Mix that my friend Sandy makes. Hers is really good. And I think there's M&Ms and other stuff in there and Cheerios or something. And then there's really, I mean, pretty much anything you can think of, different cereals and pretzels and M&Ms. And just use that same coating mixture, the white chocolate or white chocolate and peanut butter. And it just makes everything so yummy. But I think the mixture of mine is just really good. All right, then we're going to put the Joy on also with dimensionals. So let's turn all these upside down and put two on each one. I didn't look to see what time it was when I started, but I think I'm doing pretty good. Except I keep stopping to talk and read comments. I should do a recipe share post on Facebook. I should. Last year I did a thing, and this was kind of a big mistake, because I posted on Facebook that all I want for Christmas is a Christmas card with a recipe, and then I'll send you one back. Well, last year I got my recipe, and it was chicken tetrazzini, but I got so many Christmas cards, and I really did not have enough Christmas cards to send back, and I was sitting here making Christmas cards to send back to people who sent me recipes and stuff, and I'm telling you, about killed me. So I do not have enough Christmas cards made yet. So I'm not going to do that this year. But if you guys want to send me a Christmas card, I would love it, and I will try to send you one back if I get enough made. I used to send like so many, but now it's like I just really, with doing my full-time job and the videos and all this stuff, I just really don't have as much time as I used to have. And I got to get a nap in once in a while too, you know, which I did today. As soon as I finished this project, I went to go watch a Hallmark movie. I'm like, oh, good. Okay, I finished. And it was like 2:30. And I said, oh, good. I've got time to watch a Hallmark movie and take a nap. And I think I watched 10 minutes of that Hallmark movie and I was sound asleep. And I was like, whew, that was a good one. I think there's nothing better than taking a nap. That's like my favorite thing to do. Especially with my new pillow. I love that thing. All right, so there we go. So now we're going to put the snowflakes on. So we need 5 snowflakes. So we'll get these out of here. And they just pop right out. So they're all ready to go. So we need 5 of these. And you can save this if you want to. It's kind of flimsy a little bit, but you can save and punch out snowflakes. Like if you have the snowflakes die, punch them out of this paper and make some more snowflakes. I always throw this away, but one of my customers was like, oh, I'll save it. And then they can punch out more snowflakes. And I was like, well, that's a good idea. So don't throw that away if you want to keep it and do that. Okay, so then we're just going to put this on with a glue dot, and I think I'm going to go a little bit higher than, because I ended up covering up most of this gold piece right here, so I think I'm just going to go a little bit higher on these with the snowflakes, and I'm just putting one right in the middle, and I'm going to put it just a little bit, oops, I bent it. They're very delicate. You got to be careful. So I'm going to put it just a little bit higher than center. And oh my gosh, I love this card. It's so pretty. And sometimes I make cards and they're so pretty, I hate to even give them away. Do you guys do that? You make some cards and you're like, oh, these cards are just, I hate to even give them away because they're so pretty. I just want to keep them all myself and just hoard them. Put them in a box. And I probably have so many cards. It's not even funny. But I just like to save at least one or two of all the cards that I make, which is insane, I know. Because you're thinking, where are you going to put them all? I have cards everywhere. All right, so there's all of my snowflakes done. Let's get rid of all this trash. Try not to get all these on my floor. I had these grand plans of doing all this cleaning while I was off for a couple days, but I haven't done it. I really need to like mop the floor and do all that kind of stuff. All right, so we need some rhinestones, and these are the iridescent rhinestones. And we've got my ribbon. I've got four of these done, so I'm gonna have to make one for you guys. And I'm just gonna put two glue dots on this just to give it a little extra stick right in the middle there. And that one, for some reason, is really long. We'll trim it a little bit. And I love this ribbon. So I'm gonna show you in a second which three ribbons I used. These are the same three that I've been using lately because I love the way that it comes out. And it's so, just, oh, that one's not doing right. It's like one flop around. It's just a really pretty combination of ribbons. So one of these is retiring. And I'm really bummed about that, the gold one. That one's a little bit long too. So funny how like sometimes the ribbon is, the linen thread is like super curly and sometimes it's not. Now I've got to catch some comments real quick. Hold on. And I love this gold. When you cut it, you get all these little gold threads in there that are so neat. All right, one more. All right, so here's what I did. I've got these three ribbons. So we've got linen thread. This is just regular linen thread. We've got the white crinkled seam binding ribbon. So this is the white crinkled seam binding, and we've got the gold. This is the one that's retiring. And so what I did was I cut this in half. So just go right down the middle and cut it in half, right down the middle. So then you get this one and this one even. And then you get your linen thread, and you want the linen thread just a little bit longer. So I'm gonna put it maybe like an inch longer. And then you just tie a regular bow like you're tying your shoe, okay? So we've got all these ribbons here and the linen thread's a little bit longer and we're just gonna tie a little bow. So it's just like you're tying your shoe and just pull it through and then you just adjust. So pull that one. So try and keep your finger on that center knot. That is the key to making a bow, is keeping your finger on that center knot. So keep it tight while you pull. And then when you get it like you want it, then you just trim it. So, and this is supposed to look kind of messy, you know, kind of old fashioned looking. So we're gonna cut this one, this one, and this one, and then you get that, and you can fluff up your bow where you've pulled it. All right, so then we get all these little, one's a little bit longer. You get all these little gold things sticking out, which I love. So those are the three ribbons you need, the gold, the white seam binding, and the linen thread. And then you get a mess. Then we put those on with the glue dots. Good thing I have a lot of glue dots. That's still my old pack of good ones. That's wrapped the right way and not backwards. All right, so there we go. Now we need some rhinestones, so we're gonna do that, and then we're gonna do shimmer spray. Let me read some comments real quick. Where did I stop? Okay, I've been through 40. Wow, Robin, you've been through 45 states. That's good. Terry says, I envy those who can nap and then sleep at night as well. Oh, I could take a nap and really sleep all night. Mm. Your thumb just got tired. What does that mean? You're texting? Are you texting instead of typing? The Hallmark movie, A Castle for Christmas, is good. I watched a bunch of good ones. Gosh, what were they called? I can't even remember the names of them. One was Looking for The Christmas Prince, that was good. It's Time to Come Home for Christmas, that was another one that was good. There's been a bunch of good ones, but I've also seen a couple bad ones this year too that I just had to stop watching because they were just dumb. Like one was about this movie that was being filmed in this town and the girl owned the shop. That was like a terrible one. All right, so let me find my take your pick tool. I don't see it, which means I probably, oh, there it is. Okay, so we're gonna put these rhinestones on here. So if you have a snowflake or two or three, you can put it like, here's one. We could put it right there in the middle. Or you can just put them wherever you want to. So we're just gonna put sparkle, a little bit of sparkle on there. The bow is really what makes this card so beautiful. So here's one we can put right in the middle. Love it, love it. And then once we spray it, you're gonna be like, what? That is the most gorgeous card I've ever seen. It's not gonna fit. Yeah, it will. Okay. I think we could squeeze it in there, but I can. Love this card. Oh, there's a good one right there. Okay. One more. And then we're going to spray and be done. So we've got a good snowflake there. My off the page. I get carried away and in my own little zone here and forget what I'm doing. All right, now we're going to spray. Let me get my scrap paper back. So we're going to spray each one with some shimmer. And here we go. So make sure you hold it up high, like about 12 inches above your paper, and give it a couple good squirts. And then it just becomes so beautiful and sparkly. I'll hold it up so you can see it a second. Oh, love it. Okay, I'm choking on the alcohol now. All right, so here we go. We've got our five cards. Love it, love it, love it. This is my favorite one, I think. This bow came out really good. All right, so hopefully you guys can see some sparkle on here. Let me see, my screen went too far up. You guys see that? So pretty. Love it, love it, love it. Oh, make sure you guys are clicking that like button and sharing and commenting and all that good stuff for me. Make more than one card. Yep. Christmas Angel is awesome. I don't think I've seen that one. Yeah, some Hallmark are really good and some are not. Loved the one last year with Henry Winkler. I think I saw one with him, but I don't remember. There was one where he played the dad of this girl, and she picked up some, or he picked up somebody at the airport and brought him home. I used to love watching Happy Days. I thought he was so cute. All right. Thanks, you guys. I hope you enjoyed these cards. And, oh, Sherry, you're going to go out at 8:30 to watch the Michigan game. That's kind of late for football, isn't it? Usually they come on earlier than that, don't they? Oh, thanks, Sandra. It's an experience. Full timing and stamping, but entertaining. Yes. All right, I'm going back through looking to see if I missed some comments. I'm sure I did. Do you watch Hallmark movies before Thanksgiving? I watch Hallmark movies all year long. My TV pretty much stays on the Hallmark channel. So that's my favorite channel to watch because it's just like good wholesome TV, you know, and you don't have to worry about bad words and bad things happening and it's not depressing and it's always has a good ending. So I like it. All right, so there you go. All the cards from tonight. I hope you loved them. So don't forget to give me thumbs up and like, share, comment. And next time I'll have some cards to give away. I have a whole pile sitting here that I need to give away. And I didn't have time to do that tonight. So I will do that next time. And I hope you guys have a great rest of your weekend. Don't forget the sale going on. So here's the host code. Make sure you use the host code. If your order is over $50, you get the card kit. If it's over $100, you get the card kit plus rhinestones. And this is the card for the card kit this time. So it's super beautiful. And have fun tomorrow. Enjoy your day off, unless you're working. And I'll be back Tuesday, hopefully with some new stuff. And I'll show you guys some of it. So take care, everybody. And stay safe out there. And warm if you're in a cold spot. And I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.